For question 24, we have a thin converging lens forming a real image on an illuminated object. Okay, so for every single lens diagram, I think there are a few things that we must always draw. Okay, the first thing is the ray that moves from the top of the object all the way through the optical center, alright, and just goes all the way straight through, because any ray that does this, alright, there is no refraction. Okay, any ray that does this has no refraction. Now the next ray is going to be the ray that travels straight, alright, parallel to the principal axis, and upon leaving the lens, it will cut through the focal point. This is how the focal point is defined, which is the point where all rays traveling parallel to the principal axis converge to upon emerging from the lens. Right, so we already know that this particular focal point, this particular lens has a focal point at this point over here. So from here, all right, let's not clutter this particular image too much. Okay, the question says that the object is moved towards the focal point F, right? So if it's moved towards the focal point F, right, this particular focal point on the other side, okay, if we move the object any closer, then this would mean that this top ray was, for the previous image, is still going to be the same, all right? And if let's say we draw the second ray, right, you realize that the rays will meet slightly further. Of course, I'm not drawing it with a ruler, I'm not drawing it to scale, but you can see very roughly that the image does two things. The image moves further away from the lens, and the image is also larger. Okay, so it moves further and it increases in size. Answer is B.